A very good morning to all of you and welcome back in our English class. And I hope all of you are fine. And this is our first class after periodical examination one. So children, welcome back and highly appreciation for all those who have sent their projects and assignment. And their copy images, that is notebook work on time. All those who have not done or new admissions can take the time and just complete your things before the half yearly examination. So children, today we are going to study about chapter number 3 from your book Hornbill. So today's class is 11th English from Hornbill book, and we are going to study chapter number 3, Discovering Tut. The saga continues by A.R. Williams. Okay, before moving ahead, I would like to tell you about the poet, that our poet A.R. Williams was developed a very passion for reading at a very early age in the childhood, only when A.R. Williams was in fourth standard. And when an assignment was given to A.R. Williams, then he was in the condition, or she was in the condition, that able to write a book about it. So that much passionate, and belongs from Virginia district. Okay, my dear children, now moving ahead with this chapter, before we start, you should all sit along with your hornbill book, your copy and your pen. Okay, my dear children, always remember, whenever you see the video, you should be sitting along with your book and your copy and your pen, so that whatever things I teach you, like in our real classroom, you should able to note it. Okay, so the theme of this chapter is the historical archaeological event 5th January, which took place on 5th January 2005. Okay, and this chapter is based on that. What is archaeological event? We all know when the people who are in archaeology department actually goes for study, or they go on research process of the things which have been happened in past, or of the thing of historical value, then that department is known as archaeological department. So this chapter describes that historical archaeological event which took place on 5th January 2005, and actually this chapter is based on a king called Tut. Okay, that is why it is written Tut. His full name was Tutankhamun. Okay, Tutankhamun, and related investigations of the Tut mummy. What is mummy? We all know that in Egypt, when the human beings were dead, usually this mummification process started in late Egypt or in ancient Egypt. When the human beings are dead, then mummification is a process where they try to preserve the dead bodies of human being. In that process, what they do is, actually after the death of a human being, that all the internal organs are removed, they are actually dried up outside, and then they are kept in a particular specimen, or in a simple language, in a particular jars or bottles. Okay, and the internal organs like brain is removed, there is a cut in the lower part of the abdomen, they take out all the soft tissues, and then the entire body, the dead body, is covered with a salt called as natron, so that it can absorb the moisture from the body. And then what happened, that this body is allowed to dry up, and then it is wrapped in a cloth, and then it is placed in a coffin and buried, or rather it is not buried, we can call it is kept in a cave or tomb. Okay, almost the tomb is placed underground only. So that is called as mummification, where the dead bodies are preserved. Okay, so this chapter describes about mummy only, King's Tut mummy, how the investigations were carried out. So this chapter is based on the Pharaoh king, that is Tut or Tutankhamun. So I hope all of you are ready with your book. So shall we start our lesson? I'm going to read out the chapter to you. Now, he was just a teenager when he died, the last heir of a powerful family that had ruled Egypt and its empire for centuries. He was laid to the rest laden with gold and eventually forgotten. Since the discovery of his tomb in 1922, the modern world has speculated about what had happened to him, with murder being the most extreme possibility. Now living his tomb for the first time in almost 80 years, Tut has undergone a CT scan that offers new clues about his life and death and provides precise data for accurate forensic reconstruction of boyish Pharaoh. So the first paragraph starts with telling you the story is, or rather, not, it is not a story, it is more than an article. So in this chapter, it has been described that in Egypt, there was a king called as Tut or Tutankhamun. And what happened to this king? He, after becoming king, he died at a very early age. Okay? And then he was buried, or rather mummified. And then this chapter talks about what the most important part is: discovery of the tomb in 1922. Discovery of Tut's tomb in 1922. So what it is written here in this chapter, we are going to study about Tut, King Tut, who was once upon a time Egypt's ruler or Egypt's king. And at that time in ancient Egypt, this the word, last word of your first paragraph is Pharaoh, P-H-A-R-O-H. So this word is used for Pharaoh. This word Pharaoh is used in ancient Egypt for the king only. So this chapter talks about there was in ancient Egypt a king called as Tutankhamun, and he became king and he died at a very early age. There was a lot of mysteries about his death. In 1922, his tomb was discovered as he was a king and he was the last king of his dynasty. So he was mummified. So his mummy was placed in the tomb and it was discovered in 1922. So who discovered it? I will tell you. It's written. So the first paragraph talks about Tut, that he was, fourth line, he was laid to rest. Laid to rest means when his dead body was buried, he was loaded. Laden means he was loaded with gold and eventually forgotten. Means that time it was believed that all these kings who was after their death were buried along with their things because they believe in afterlife. Since the discovery of his tomb in 1922, the modern world has speculated. Speculated means they have actually given a lot of theories without any evidences about what had happened to him. Means historians believe that most probably his death was not a natural death. This king Tutankhamun died because of murder or something mishappening has happened to him. And now the dead body is being taken away, means that mummy is taken away from its tomb. And what for it has been taken? It is actually taken coming out means the mummy is taken out from his tomb for CT scan process. Means the archaeologist wants to do certain investigation or research process, and that's why King Tut mummy is being brought from his tomb. And since his tomb was also not known, it was discovered in 1922, and it is taken out, or by the archaeological department. They are actually taking that mummy out of the tomb for the CT scan process. So this chapter is actually based on that scenario when Tut's mummy was brought out of the tomb on 5th January 2005. Okay, my dear children, so this was a small intro of the chapter, that it is all about a pharaoh king called as Tutankhamun. Okay, so we are going to read this chapter, and in the further part of this chapter, the entire chapter is based on the incident that how in 1922 a British archaeologist named Howard Carter, this is very, very important, he discovered Tut's tomb. Okay, who discovered? The next phase we are going to study or read the chapter, that in 1922 British archaeologist Howard Carter actually discovered Tut's tomb, and then he started a research process on this. This chapter focuses on this event also. And then further, how on 5th January 2005, how the CT scan process was carried out. Okay, so when Howard Carter actually found this Tut's tomb in 1922, when he researched on his mummy, or rather on his dead body, he focused more on the things which were actually put along with Tut's mummy he was buried along with those things, like he was buried along with his jewelries, along with his daily things, all those things we are going to study. So this chapter, I'm giving you a small introduction while we are moving in a second paragraph. This chapter talks about that how British archaeologist in 1922, whose name was Howard Carter, he discovered the Tut's tomb, and what all he discovered, what all things he found out after taking out that mummy. And then again on 5th January 2005, CT scan was done. So many year gap was there. And what were the findings? This chapter also described. And in between, in 1965 also, this chapter describes how there has been a repeated scrutinizing of Tut's mummy. Okay, this chapter not only talk about the discovery by Howard Carter of Tut's tomb, then his discovery or his research process, then on 5th January what all happened, that has been also described very nicely. But in the middle of that, in this events, in 1965 also, what the doctors or what the researchers have actually found out, this chapter talks also about that. Okay, so we are moving in the second paragraph. An angry wind stirred up ghostly dust devils. Actually, ghostly dust devils here is related to the storm. Okay, storm, a strong desert dust storm. Okay, that's why it has been metaphorically regarded as ghostly dust devil. As King Tut was taken from his resting place, in the ancient Egyptian cemetery known as the Valley of Kings. So here it is talking about that where Tut tomb was there. Okay, so it was in an ancient Egyptian cemetery known as Tut's grave was where? It was in Valley of Kings. Okay. And if you want to see where the valley lies, you can see in your next page. So Tut's grave or Tut's tomb was situated where? In the Valley of Kings. And on the day when city scan was carried out, there was a great dust storm was occurring or happening, and dark bellied cloud has scudded across the desert sky all day, and now were veiling the stars in cascade gray. Very importantly, that's why I read it very slowly. Dark bellied cloud means cloud that were very dark in color. So belly has been a personification of this, has been you personification device, literal device has been used here, bellied, for the word bellied they have used. So dark bellied clouds means dark clouds were moving, scudded means they were moving in the sky all day, and in the night means this CT scan process was carried in the evening, later evening part. So now these dark clouds were covering all the stars in cascade gray. Actually, cascade is, we can call, two meanings are there. First of all, casket is a precious box, or rather a box meant for carrying the precious ornaments or jewelry, or rather casket is referred to a coffin also in American English. So it seems that all the stars were like in a box. Okay, they had been covered up. It was 6 p.m. on 5th January. The world's most famous mummy glided head first into the CT scanner, brought here to probe the lingering medical mysteries of this little understood young ruler who died more than 3,300 years ago. So what happened? This paragraph talks about the day on 5th January 2005. So this paragraph talks about 5th January 2005. What happened on that day? Around 6 p.m. this King Tut's mummy was brought out for CT scan. Okay, and this process was carried out by the archaeologist, or rather archaeological department, who actually wants to know the death or the reason or the cause of the Tut's death way behind. How many years have gone? 3,300 years ago. And they want to solve the mystery that why this king died at an early age. So researchers were trying to reach to a conclusion through the study. Okay, that what is the reason of his death. So on that day, what was the scenario? The entire sky was totally dark the entire day, and the angry wind was there, and that's why it was, has been narrated, a ghostly devil, dust devils means storm wind. All afternoon, the usual line of tourists from around the world had descended into the cramped rock cut tombs on 26 feet underground to pay their respect. Means this on 25th January 2005 at 6 p.m. around 6 p.m. the CT scan was process was about to take place, and the tomb which was actually discovered that needs to be actually what, digged for 25 feet underground. Okay. And it was a really, we can call, a very congested area. And the entire afternoon on that particular day, what happened, you know? Tourists all around the world were getting in inside to the term, and they were trying to fit themselves. Descendant means moved. Cram means a very small space, and they were trying to get into that small space. They are 26 feet underground. They were just trying to go in that 26 feet underground where his tomb, where his coffin was there. They gazed at the murals on the walls of the burial chamber and peered at Tut's gilded face. So these tourists were actually seeing, or rather staring, on the murals. Here the word murals has been used for all the artwork which was on the walls of the tomb. So all the tourists were visualizing, like they were staring to all those artworks, to all the painting, to all the drawing on the wall. All the drawing on the wall and the painting on the wall have been referred to as murals. Okay, my dear children. And they were actually looking for the Tut's face, but it was all wrapped, okay, as it was a mummy that entire afternoon. So the most striking feature of this mummy shaped outer coffin lid, some visitor read from guidebooks in whispered, others stood silently, perhaps pondering Tut's untimely death in late teens, or wondering with a shiver if the pharaoh curse, death or misfortune falling upon those who disturbed him was really true. So that entire afternoon, the day on 5th January, this tourist were actually trying to go into that under 25th feet underground area, and some were actually looking to the guidebook, some were actually talking among themselves, some were after these guides, what had happened, and some were actually having a notion, this tourist, that oh my god, if we are doing this process, all these things might, there can be a curse. So they have a different unnatural belief. The mummy is in a very bad condition because of what Carter did in 1920s, said Zahi Hawass, Secretary General of Egypt's Supreme Council of Antiquities. So underline this line, that who is Zahi Hawass? He is the actually Secretary Council of the Supreme Council of Antiquities. He is the Secretary General of Egypt. Okay, so what he is telling, today this chapter or this particular paragraph is talking about the date 5th January 2005, and here the Secretary General of Egypt of Antiquities is telling that the mummy is in a very bad condition, because it is not the first time that mummy is coming out of the tomb. In 1920s, means in 1922, Howard has done much damage. How much damage, what damage he has done? He was a British archaeologist, I told you. So what he did is written in the later half of the chapter. So Zahi Hawass is telling, as he leaned over the body for long first looked. So while he actually he was looking at the mummy like this, he said, mummy is in a very bad condition because what Carter did, that has made mummy into bad condition. What type Carter did? So it is written that Carter, Howard Carter, I already told you, that was a British archaeologist who in 1922 discovered Tut's tomb after years of futile searching. Futile means vain. Faltu mein idhar udhar, matlab itna samay vyarth barbaad karne ke baad, in 1922, British archaeologist Howard Carter was able to discover the tomb of whom? Of Egyptian king Tut. And now it is the day is 5th January when this mummy is brought out for CT scan. So this mummy was discovered late back, okay, and what it is written, its contents through hastily has ransacked, okay, its antiquity was surprisingly complete. They remain the richest royal collection ever found and have become part of Pharaoh's regent. Means it is this paragraph is talking all about that, how the contents means whatever it was inside the coffin or inside the tomb was actually it was very fastly, it has been, the things were tried to discovered and were surprisingly complete, means nothing has been disturbed. Everything was complete in the tomb. Even Carter actually 1922 discovered it and he did an investigation, but nothing was missing in that tomb. And when the tomb was discovered, it was full of like, oh my God, how much rich this king was. It is written over there, see, they remain the richest royal collection ever found and have become the part of Pharaoh's legends. Stunning artifacts in gold. Oh my God. All the beautiful jewelries of gold, their eternal brilliance meant to guarantee resurrection. Resurrection means life after death. Okay. And cause a sensation at the time of discovery and still get the most attention. But the Tet was also buried with everyday things he would want in afterlife. Board games, a bronze razor, linen undergarment, case of food and wine. So here it has been written that Tut's body was buried along with, he was laden with full gold jewelries, all the places like his anklets, his bracelets, his necklace full of gold. It was, that was giving a look what a magnificent rich king he was. Not only all these things, but all the everyday things like razor, like his board game, like his dress, like his food baskets, everything, because this Egyptian people believed life after death. They believe that the body is going to meet the soul, or rather there will be another life or afterlife after death. That's why they bury the dead bodies along with these things. And when the tomb was discovered, all these things were also found out along with Tut's dead body. Okay. Now, the second last paragraph. After a month of carefully recording the funerary treasures. Okay. Funerary treasure means all those things which were buried along with the king. What all things I told you, all the jewelries, all the everyday things, all his clothes, all his bronze razor, his food items, his board games, everything. Means Carter, when he found this Tut tomb in 1922, when Carter found it off, then for months he did investigation. For months he started noting all the funerary treasure, he started recording. So when 1922, when Howard Carter discovered the tomb, what he did, number one thing, he for months he recorded about the funerary treasures. What do you mean by funerary treasures? Means all those things which were buried along with the dead bodies. So he kept on recording for months. This process was carried out by Howard Carter. So now this chapter is telling about the first investigation of Tut's mummy, which was carried out. This is, we can call it as a first investigation of Tut's mummy. When it was found in 1922 by Howard Carter. सबसे पहले 1922 में जब उसका मम्मी मिला था उसके टॉम में, तो Howard Carter did the research work and for months he focused on all these things like funerary treasures. He focused on what all things he was buried along. He kept making the records. Who? Howard Carter. And then Carter began investigation. Taking his three nested coffin, opening the first, he found a shroud adorned with garlands of willow and olive leaves. So second thing, what he found in the coffins were, how many coffins were there? 3 coffins one by one inside in a decreasing manner were placed. When he opened, he found a cloth there was, and what was there? Along with that piece of cloth which was wrapped. Shroud means a cloth which was used to wrap the dead body. What all were there? He recorded that lot of garlands were there, lot of olive leaves, wild cereally uncultivated things, okay, lotus petals and corn flowers in faded evidence of burial in March or April. So that things, all those things, flowers, uncultivated plantations, all those things gave the indication that Tut or Tutankhamun was buried in the month of March or April, because these vegetation of flowers were available in that time in Egypt only. Okay, when he finally reached to the mummy, though he ran into trouble, okay, the ritual resins, okay, had hardened, cementing Tut to the bottom of his solid gold coffin. So first thing he recorded about all the treasures. Second thing he investigated about the coffins, that how his dead body was actually wrapped in a cloth, and along with that piece of cloth, a lot of flowers and uncultivated vegetation were also put along with it. That he noted. Then coming to the dead body or the mummy of Tut, then what was the biggest trouble for him? That Howard Carter found that his dead body was stuck. As you stick something to paste with the glue or fevicol, like that, his dead body became cemented rather, or very much stick to the gold coffin. Oh my God, that coffin was made of gold. And why the dead body was stick to the cold coffin? It got stuck to the gold coffin because of resins. It has been written, it is because of the ritual resins. This resin is a flammable product, or it is a highly insoluble, we can call it solution, or rather a semi-solid type of thing, which is used for mummification process. Okay, when the dead body, when the body, dead body is actually preserved for mummification, then this material, this chemical is placed inside the dead body to preserve it for long. Okay, when they start removing the internal organs, first they remove the brain by putting a hook, long hook wire, and then they remove the abdomen soft tissues, everything. Then they keep the dead body in sun for drying up, and after that this resin is applied to the dead body as a protective chemical. Okay, so because of this protective chemical called as resin, this dead body got pasted, or rather got stuck to the gold coffin. So how the investigation process was to be carried out? Because Howard Carter was thinking that he is going to take out the dead body from the coffin like this, and he will start his process or research work. But he was not able to lift the dead body or the mummy from the coffin. And that was a gold coffin. Oh my God. And what has been written? No amount of legitimate force could move them. It was so hardly stuck with that gold coffin, that Carter wrote later what was to be done. Carter didn't found any particular solution for this problem. Then how I can just remove the dead body or mummy from that gold coffin? The sun can beat down like a hammer this far south in Egypt, and Carter tried to use it to loosen the resins for several hours. Set the mummy outside in a blazing sunshine that heated it to 149 degrees Fahrenheit. Nothing budged. Nothing moved. He moved. Budged means moved. He reported with a scientific detachment that the consolidated material had to be chiseled away from beneath the limbs and trunk before it was possible to raise the king's remain. So my dear children, when the research work came to the fourth stage for Howard Carter, first investigated about the funerary treasures, then he came to the coffins, he opened one by one, and when he was about to take that mummy out of the coffin, then he was not able to do because the resins made the dead body stuck to the coffin very tightly. So what he did, he put that coffin outside in the sun, which was actually the heat was 149 degree Fahrenheit, but he thought that this chemical might melt away. Hamare हॉट कॉटर साहब को लगा कि बाहर धूप में रखूंगा तो ये रेजिन ये केमिकल पिघल जाएगा एंड आई वुड एबल टू लिफ्ट द डेड बॉडी और मम्मी फ्रॉम द कॉफिन वेरी इजली एंड कैरी ऑन द रिसर्च प्रोसेस. बट ऐसा कुछ नहीं हुआ. द डेड बॉडी द केमिकल डिडंट गॉट लूजिंग अवे एंड देन व्हाट हैपेंड. देयर इज वन वर्ड रिटन ऑन पेज नंबर 25 फर्स्ट पैराग्राफ दैट ही रिपोर्टेड विद साइंटिफिक Scientific detachment means this word is used for the person who works with a brain, not with emotions. Means if the emotions were attached, then you cannot work very nicely. So without taking the emotion in due consideration, what Howard Carter decided, he decided that that consolidated material means the mummy of the King Tutankhamun Tut needs to be chisel. You all know tool, it should be started. He uses the chisel to what? To actually remove the mummy from the solid or that gold coffin. So he has to do. He does not want to do, but for to carry the research work on his mummy, he has to carry out the process of chiseling. So he just जो भी हमारा घर में कुछ भी इफ वी आई वॉन्ट टू रिमूव देन वी यूज द चीजर लाइक दिस एंड वी ट्राई टू ब्रेक एंड मेक द थिंग्स आउट व्हेन इट इज गॉट स्टक वेरी बैडली. सो सेम वे ही जस्ट चीजर एंड इन दिस कोर्स यू नो व्हाट हैपेंड. Tut's dead body was highly damaged. They break almost, Howard Carter almost broke all the joints. So in parts, the dead, that mummy was, it came out. One leg came out, then another leg he chiseled away like this, then the hands, then. So in the entire, the single mummy got broken into pieces in this due course of chiseling away. And now you understood why Zaheer Abbas, that secretary, told the mummy is in very bad condition. This he told in on the date 5th January 2005. Looking on the condition that the mummy is very bad condition, what Carter did to it means while doing his research process, Carter actually damaged the entire mummy just to carry on the research. So on January 5th, when the CT scan, that mummy was being brought out of his tomb, Zaheer Abbas stole these words or he uttered this word. Now you get to know, because of this chiseling away, his body, or rather the mummy, was broken into pieces. Okay, now we are carrying up. In his defense, Carter really had little choice. If he hadn't cut the mummy free, these most certainly would have circumvented. Circumvented means, here it means smarty or outwitted, or in a very simple manner, they can find a way to tackle the guards. Means Carter said, if I would have not done it like that, यदि मैंने join सब कुछ हथौड़ी से तोड़ के बाहर नहीं निकाला होता तो क्या होता कि चोर क्या करते, would have fooled the guards to take out the gold artifacts. So that's why Carter said, I have little choice, because after the discovery of the Tut's mummy and seeing that he was laid with all the golden things and lot of magnificent funerary treasure was there, so the thieves might actually find a way to tackle the guards. That is called as circumvented. So that's why I have to do, means mere ko research process complete karke wapas usko tomb mein dalna tha, and then it can be locked forever, so thieves can never do any damage. Otherwise everything will be on the head of whom? The Howard Carter, because he took a special permission for that. So the guards then ripped it apart to remove the gold. In Tut's time, the royals were fabulously wealthy, and they thought or hoped they could take their riches with them for his journey to the great beyond. King Tut was lavish with glittering golds, precious collar, inlaid necklaces and bracelet rings, amulets, ceremonial apron, sandals, sheets of his fingers and toes, and now iconic inner coffin and marks. So when his dead body, or rather his mummy, was taken out in parts, what all Carter recorded was King Tut was not laid only with ornaments, but briefly he described that how bracelets were there, how necklaces were there, how apron was also there, outer covering, ceremonial apron was there, the cloth which is worn outside the of the cloth, okay, and then how amulets means that is also an ornament which is used to protect you from evils and dangers. So he recorded all the things, and that reveals that King Tut was one of the richest king of his dynasty, although the last king. To separate Tut from his adornments, Carton men removed the mummy's head and several nearly every major joint. Oh my God. Just to study about what is the value of the ornaments, or what ornaments, they just actually break down the Tut's mummy into pieces. The skull was apart and everything, it has been regioned. The major joints were apart. Once they had finished, they reassembled the remains on a layer of sand in a wooden box with padding that concealed the damage, the bed where Tut now rest. So what they did after their investigation or research process was over, when it was over means when Howard Carter along with his team, he finished his research process, in that research he just broke down every point, part of the mummy, and then in a box, by placing the sand, they reassembled the dead body, or rather mummy, in a proper way that could hide whatever they have done, the damage to the mummy. Okay, so here we find out that this Howard Carter investigation was much focused on the jewelries, or rather on the ornaments, or on the treasure which was buried along with King Tutankhamun or King Tut, or along with his mummy. Okay, his total focus of investigation in 1922 or after 1922 was on these things, on the funerary treasures. Okay, this is revealed. Archaeology has now changed substantially in the intervening decades, focusing less on treasure and more on the fascinating details of life and intriguing mysteries of death. It also uses more sophisticated tools, including medical technology. 1968, more than 40 years after Carter's discovery, anatomy professor X-ray the mummy revealed a startling, very shocking fact. Startling means shocking fact. Beneath the resin that cakes his wrist, his breastbone and front ribs are missing. So first investigation was in 1922 when Howard Carter, it was by 1922 by Howard Carter. Okay. And how he focused on funerary treasure, we have seen. The second investigation on Tut's mummy was in 1948, and on that the scenario changes. The writer writes that from 1922 to 1948, now the focus has shifted. The X-ray was conducted. Okay. In 1922, just Howard Carter took the mummy out and just notified all the things. But in 1948, after 40 years almost, what it has been done, it has been written. Sorry, not 48, it is 68. So it is 68. Who take it out? Professor. Okay, anatomy professor. Actually, what is anatomy? Anatomy is a field or a branch of science where you study lot about the entire body parts, including your skull to your toe. Okay, all the bones, all the muscles, all the nerve supply, very, very deeply. So that professor of anatomy, when he did the X-ray 1968 of Tut's mummy, he found out that some of his front ribs and breast bones were missing. Okay, then nobody know. They are missing when Howard Carter did the damage, some of the ribs got broken, or from startingly that bones or ribs were not there. Nobody know, because there was no evidence. Now what happened? Today diagnostic imaging can be done with computed tomography or CT scan, by which hundreds of x-rays in cross sections are put together like slices of bread to create a three-dimensional virtual body. What more could a CT scan reveal of Tut than an x-ray? And could it answer two of the biggest questions still lingering about him? How did he die, and what was his age at the time of his death? Now the writer is talking all about that today, at present day, instead of this x-ray, we use the CT scan. CT scan full form is computed tomography, and it is also the advanced form of x-ray. In x-ray, only one side you can just take out, but in CT scan, three-dimensional virtual image of an entire piece is formed. So that gives a more good idea what has happened. So they want to answer the two questions: that how was his death, means what was the reason of his death, and how old was King Tutankhamun at the time of his death. Okay, my dear children. Now what happened is, King Tut's demise was a big event even by a royal standards. He was the last of his family line, and his funeral was death rattle of a dynasty. Means he was the last king of his dynasty, and his funeral was like a death rattle. Death rattle is actually a sound, the grudging sound is produced when a person becomes breathless or about to die. It appears in the throat, okay, when something is stuck or is obstructing your throat. So that was the scene when King Tut died. Okay, my dear children. Now, in the next paragraph, it is all talked about what? It is all talked about Tut's family or family history, which we will be dealing in another part. Okay, so this was part one, and we will be dealing in another part of it. Okay, my dear children, I hope you understand. I'm not giving you home assignment at present. I will be giving you another part. So thank you, all of you, and just keep on looking the videos. If you don't understand, look it twice. Now till we meet next time, have a nice day. Goodbye.